I think it's time that you and I decided to draw. Hey everybody, welcome back to Draw with Ellie. For today's episode, I thought we'd switch it up a bit. So in the first episode, we did ink drawing of a Disney character. But today we're going to do a watercolor pencil painting of a Studio Ghibli character. And she is Nausicaä from the movie Nausicaä of the Valley of the Wind. And I have to admit, I'm actually really not familiar with watercolor pencils. But I got these for Christmas, and I thought they'd be fun to try. They were only about 6 pounds, so that's about $8, just off Amazon. So they're really fun. They cover a multitude of sins, and I've never completed a piece with them, so this is going to be an experiment, but I hope you enjoy it. Okay, so I debated with myself for a bit whether or not I should start with the skin, and I feel like I should. Like, the art student in me says I should, but I'm not going to because I don't think that's as exciting for you. So I'm going to start with her hair. So what I'm going to do is, with watercolor pencils, I have found in my few experimentations that you just need to put a very basic amount of shading. And then the actual painting part is what brings it to the next level. So what I'm gonna do is okay, the reason why all the lines are already in colored pencil is because in my practices, at first I did it with ink, so I was painting over an ink drawing, but I found that in the end the color was too soft compared to the really hard lines of the ink. And so then I tried it with a normal pencil, but the gray of a pencil looked kind of weird than with the soft pastel palette of colored pencils. So then I did another little experiment of doing where I actually outline with the watercolored pencils, and I was afraid that that would make it really runny when you added water, but it actually doesn't. The line holds. But that was just in a little doodly bob, so not on an actual big scale like this. But so if you are interested in doing watercolored pencils, my advice is not to get too caught up with perfection, because the water is going to do what it will. And so I'm just mapping out where I know I want color, where I want the deepest parts to be orange. She's a ginger, if you haven't seen the movie. I'm filming on a cloudy day compared to last time, so I needed to have more lights around. Hopefully that doesn't create too many shadows. You guys can see what's going on. We don't make mistakes. We just make happy accidents. PBS did a really cool Bob Ross remix that I've been jamming out to. They did a really good Reading Rainbow and Mr. Rogers one as well. If you're into that sort of thing, you should go check it out on the PBS channel. But yeah, it's kind of funny that my first Ghibli fan art is of Nausicaä, because Nausicaä is not one of my favorite Ghibli movies. The reason why I chose her is because she's very colorful and she's a main character. So I thought, if you're a fan of Ghibli, then you definitely know who she is. Okay, so let me show you what I've done. Focus, please. Okay, good. Yes, yes. Excellent. It's all going according to plan. Since she's wearing a really nice bright blue outfit, I'm actually going to add a little bit of blue in her hair. There, just really soft. So that when I'm actually painting, there'll be a hint of blue. See, I feel like I should get a little crazy with the colors. Just a little bit. So I'm going to take a slightly lighter orange. Just do a bit of blending. Again, this is just so that when you're actually adding water to these, and things are going crazy, there's more than just the one color. So now I'll have blue and two different oranges. But yes, if you're not familiar with Studio Ghibli, they're kind of the Disney of Japan. They're the ones who did My Neighbor Totoro, Howl's Moving Castle, Spirited Away. Nausicaä was actually their first movie, but it was technically before it was called Studio Ghibli in the early 80s, I believe.
I should do all the colored pencil first before I do the water.
Even though I really want to add water right away because it makes it so pretty.
But I'm going to have patience, and I'm going to add the blue. So yeah, I'm really excited to be making episode 2. A lot of people seemed to enjoy the first episode. It was really fun hearing different people's reactions, and I'm so glad people enjoyed it. Shout out to the people like Brianna and Ross, who said they watch it while drawing. That was really cool. And you know, that's what I want! I think it's so fun to, this idea of doing art at the same time as other people. Even if you're not in the same room, you're definitely sharing in a moment. And some might even say an energy, if you want to go that route. One thing I'm still, experimenting with these pencils that's going to take a lot of practice is how much to actually apply and how much to leave white
and let the water take over.
I'm just adding the basics. I'm sorry I can't do more zoomed in. It was so difficult finding a way to put my camera up at all. So each setup is going to be a little different until I can figure out the best way to angle a camera. I tried to recreate last episodes because I was really happy with that, but I couldn't figure out exactly how I had it propped up, so that just didn't happen. But that's life. Ooh, that's life. Now, the hand position that Nausicaä, I've drawn her in, is actually inspired by an Alphonse Mucha piece,
which was not intentional when I started drawing, but when I got to the hand, I'm like, wait, there's a Mucha poster like this. And Mucha was an Art Nouveau artist.
Even if you don't recognize his name, you'd probably recognize his art. He's just one of those artists that you see on postcards and magnets and that kind of thing. I need more shadow there. So yeah, if you guys want to see more Ghibli or Disney, there are a lot of Ghibli and Disney movies.
So I'd be happy to do a series where I do all of them. See what I have done. I've done, as a Scot might say, though I'm not very good at the accent.
When I was thinking about starting a YouTube channel, I was so worried about the views and stuff, and you know, I was like, okay, making content won't be cool, but it'll be even cooler to have a community and everything. But once I actually posted that first video, it was like, no matter how many views it gets, it's just fun hearing like a few people saying they watched it at the end of the day and it cheered them up. Or it made them want to draw, which is the goal. I want y'all to draw, yo.
Ooh, see, I can get very shy about shading, but
you gotta just go for it. I feel there's a temptation to color in as little as possible.
But you gotta color in something.
Otherwise, you won't have enough stuff when you're adding a paintbrush. If you've never tried watercolor pencil before, just wait for the magic that's gonna happen. I should say, shout out to James from
my Dundee art class. Hi, James. Cookie.
Because he was the first one who let me use his watercolor pencil. So I was like,
dang, these are actually really cool. I wanna keep them. And I didn't keep them, but I got my own. Now this is I'm also gonna go back and add some dark blue to the darkest parts of her dress. The flowers, I'm actually going to combine colors. Because I think it'd be really pretty if they were different colors. Like not just purple and red.
So this, I feel I should say this drawing, I didn't just draw on colored pencils. I sketched it out and pencils first, and then I just went over my pencil line with these colored pencils. I would say this drawing took like 30-40 minutes.
Not counting lining it again, that was another 10 minutes, I guess.
I didn't plan it much like I should have. Usually, if you find that you're unhappy with how a lot of your pieces are being composed, like you don't like how you where you put her arm or how you made her hair flow, doing thumbnails
just really little sketches is a excellent way to map out what you're going to draw, so when you actually are on the paper for your final piece, you're not just randomly improvising your drawing. Because that's when a lot of the frustration with art can come into play, when you're unhappy with what you're doing because you didn't actually think about what you're doing.
How's that looking, eh? Oh, focus, please. Oh, thank you, darling. That was so kind of you.
It took me a little bit to film a second episode, because I was torn on who to draw. I knew I wanted to do color, since I really like color and painting. I didn't want to just do ink drawings on my channel. It's too bad that when my hand's in the way, you can't see exactly what I'm doing. But to avoid that, I'd have to get some crazy camera set up where it's like floating above me, or some noob is actually holding the camera for me. But that's not gonna happen anytime soon. Maybe when I hit 1,000 subscribers, if that ever happens. Then we can do all the tricks, darling. But for now, we settle with this. But I'm gonna add a little bit of blush. And her lips look really small because I just drew the little line for her mouth, not the actual, like, lippy part. Yesterday I saw Zootopia for the first time, and it was so good! I had heard it was good, but man, it was good.
Added a little bit of blush.
I'm really pushing it. But I'm gonna add some more. Who knows what could happen? Do what you do, just keep on adding blush. You can never have too much.
Added some lip color.
If you haven't seen any Ghibli movies, Nausicaä's good, but again, it's not my fave.
I mean, the first Ghibli movie I saw was My Neighbor Totoro when I was like around 4. So yeah, I was introduced to anime pretty early on. I didn't stand a chance, really, living in a world without anime. But I'm glad, because I love it. My Neighbor Totoro will always have a special place in my heart. I've seen every Ghibli movie except for The Wind Rises.
But I do want to see that one. I only just saw The Secret World of Arrietty, like, a few months ago, so I'm still catching up.
But there are a lot of really underrated ones. Like, there are the great famous ones like Spirited Away, oh, which is so good. Howl's Moving Castle, Princess Mononoke, which I've noticed people here in Scotland seem to really like, which is cool.
I like a lot of the other ones as well, like Whisper of the Heart, which came out the year I was born.
Also, that was the same year Pocahontas came out, so a lot of good stuff was coming out, if you know what I mean. You want to put as much color as you can before you add water, because once the water is a-flowing, you want to add a cheeky little red or something, it's not going to be happy with you, and you might be punished. But yes, my favorite Ghibli movies, Whisper of the Heart is a good one.
Ocean Waves is a really good one, but it's the only one now that hasn't been released in English.
It's about just young people in the 90s, first at school and then kind of after, in a romance and reflective. It's so good. It's interesting because it wasn't directed by Miyazaki. What they did is, in the 90s, they told the youngest animators and writers, just the youngest people on the Ghibli team, they allowed them to make a movie. And so they made it like about drama of people their age. And the movie went over budget, it took too long, and it didn't get a lot of good marketing, and so it's really been kind of the lost Ghibli movie. For a long time, Only Yesterday also hadn't been translated, but Only Yesterday now recently got translated by Disney. But I still recommend you see the original,
because sometimes Disney voice acting is, you know, dubious.
Yeah, I think with these leaves, I want to add, like, little blues and lighter and maybe lighter greens and maybe some yellow, too, I think is really nice.
The great thing about plants is you just really can do what you want. You don't need to be worried. Like, I don't worry about making an accurate plant. I'm no botanist.
Yeah, this is a subtle difference, but I like to think it'll be worth it when I'm actually painting. Yeah, the only time I've practiced these is in the class where James let me use his. And then I got a coloring book, and so I practiced these on there. And they might be my favorite traditional means of painting that I can do at home, because I don't have, like, you know, like, canvases and stuff, which is why I do a lot of my painting digitally, because it's just, it's no cleanup, it's just easy. However, you do have drama with Photoshop quitting out, so that's life.
Alright, you guys. Remember it as it was.
I'm sorry I'm doing everything horizontal here.
Ooh, Nausicaä. Where to get your flowers?
Okay, we're gonna add now the water.
I only have one dirty paintbrush. But with it, we would create a masterpiece!
Oh my god, I'm a little nervous because I actually like how this looks.
But you gotta have faith in your heart. No one's gonna take it from you.
I have made the first stroke. I don't know if you can even tell a difference in the camera yet.
Wow. Whoa.
What? It's like using the blur tool on Photoshop.
We don't make mistakes. We just make happy accidents.
Give a little touch. Give a little push. Poop on the canvas. Well, I think you can tell on the camera that,
it's just getting blendy.
I think the watercolor will become most obvious when we're doing, like, her dress. I mean, it's making a difference up close.
But I can't see the camera.
I am so glad that I made a YouTube channel. It's just been so fun. Had to get verified as a channel so I could post something longer than 15 minutes, which involved, like, I swear, like a secret agent call. It's a little hard to explain, but you need to confirm that you're not like a robot, so they like call you. And you can, it's like in The Incredibles when Mr. Incredible early in the movie gets his like secret agent assignment. Because Google calls you, because you know, Google owns YouTube now. They own everything! And they call you, and it's just this like really intense sounding chick who's a robot, or maybe an android at this point. Who's to say? And she's just like, hello, I am going to give you your code. And you're like, okay, okay. But she doesn't care about what you say. It doesn't matter if you say, give me a second, let me get a pen. She doesn't care. And she just says the code. And then she says it again. And she's like,
never repeat this code to anyone.
And I was like, wait, but what? And she was like, do not call us back. Do not contact us. Goodbye. And it freaking blew up. No, it just hung up, but
I like it. Let's do the skin now.
Oh, but I'm gonna blend the blush.
There's no going back. It's too much for Mr. Incredible.
I am in such a Incredibles state of mind. I don't know why. Probably because the other day, actually, I read, you know, about the sequel coming out in 2019. Would have appreciated even like a 2018 release, but no. They had to make another Cars movie. Because everybody wants Cars 3. Not that I'm bitter, of course. See what I did? You can see how now it looks like I painted her hair.
If you believe in magic in a young girl's heart.
Now let's move on to the dress. So last time Loki was in the episode, but
he decided he had better things to do, like eat and poop and sleep.
So yeah, I don't think we're gonna get a cat cameo this time, people.
This is getting messy.
But hey, at least I have on camera preserved what it was before I added paint. I think I need more water. Yeah.
Oh. Oh, yeah, that's nice.
Baby, I like it. The way you paint her glove.
Maybe people will feel a little divided on if they liked it better this colored pencil. But hey, at least if that's the case, you did get to see it as just colored pencil.
So I hope you're happy, Kowalski. Kowalski!
Let me know on Facebook or on YouTube, wherever you talk to me, if you prefer watching me color or watching me ink. Also, I should point out, I'm not doing this on watercolor paper, which is kind of naughty. Art students unleashed. You know, for drawing and stuff, I just use number 2 pencil, mechanical pencil. The only special equipment I have is definitely my tablet, which is a bamboo Wacom tablet, I think size medium. I got it on Amazon back in 2009, so I've been using a tablet for years. It's a part of me now. At this point, it'd be difficult to mess the flower up because they're not based on any real flower.
Only the flowers of my dreams.
I'm having fun. I like this drawing better than I liked last episode's. I think this one has... it's just a little more interesting to me. Ooh, it looks nice with the green. When you wish upon a star, it makes no difference who you are. If you do like drawing, and you like drawing
with Ellie,
feel free to send me what you drew while hanging out. Ross, I know you did that last episode.
You drew me a beautiful fan art. My first one.
Wow, I gotta say, maybe it's just because it's color and color has an advantage, but I really like this better than last eps. I was happy with last episodes, but you know. I actually really like this. This might even go on DeviantArt and Tumblr. Yeah, I should be working from left to right so I don't smear it when I cross over. But I didn't do that, so now I have to do the old bird's eye painting technique. Which means I can't rest my wrist on the paper. Okay. Now I'm going into the eye. Save yourself! Uh-oh. I had to make some executive decisions there. Now, the idea was to add more stuff behind her, but I don't know, people, I know. Okay, I want to show you guys what's going on. So we'll crash sometime. Okay. Yeah, it needs to dry. The paper's all bubbled. So doing a big finish shot is just difficult to do right now. Yeah, some parts I liked better as just colored pencils. Some parts, I'm like, that looks really cool as a watercolor thing. You can see it's still really wet on her face. But I'm very happy with how her face came out. I like the whole piece. You know, it's messier when it's painted. It was a lot more restrained. You can see I still have some pencils in the background for more leaves. I'm happy to say that for the moment, this is done. All right, everyone, that's all for today. If you liked painting with me, then be sure to subscribe or just check out the next episode. And if you have any suggestions for next time, just let me know. Bye-bye!